hearing you correctly, are you saying that you can move the cord quicker?
Earlier. What, do you guys have a net down there every night, or just you guys just hang out?
No, it's just about June. But there's a lot of species earlier.
One of the reasons why they put the birdie down there. exactly. Now, on the PM model, it has active power factor correction, so that means its switching frequency can change, but generally it hangs out around 180 kilohertz, between 75 and 180. And the same thing, it's a birdie, and they decrease in amplitude very quickly. They're very well filtered, very highly regulated. They are adjustable in voltage if you need a little more. You pop the cover off, you twist the right pot, you got more volts.
$160 a piece. If you know where to get them.
Yeah, personally, I think the Samlux supplies are like probably one of the best ones on the market for this use case. And it's honestly one of the biggest like improvements you can make to your shack. If you've got an old transformer based power supply, you'll no longer have that thing just pouring out heat. You won't be coupling noise into your microphones from the big giant transformer. A lot of nice benefits.
I've never heard of that. Actually,
also,
someone actually using out here though.
If you ever have any problems, like Samlux support is amazingly technical and competent. Like,
I have two of them actually. I bought that one 2014.
And they put me in touch with one of their engineers there, and we got into it, and it ended up being an issue on my side, but yeah, it was nice.
And that's why all my Astrons went in the dumpster.
Have to be Arnold Schwarzenegger to pick up 50 amps worth of 50 amps worth of 12 volts anymore.
Yeah, I got a Masteron 50 at the office as a backup in case I lose one of my Motorola supplies. You know, it's just a just in case, but even that's fruitless really because I bought a Chinese one, PowerTech, I think. About a year ago, and it works just fine on the bench. There's no reason for anything more complicated than that.
Yeah, so these Samlux, they're rated at 30 amps continuous. The actual current limit is about 37 and a half. The output ripple is less than 100 millivolts peak to peak at full load. They're adjustable from 12 and a half to 15 volts. The plus minus 0.1 volt regulation.
Hey, but John, you gotta send him an email with the place to get them, because if you don't get them where you sent me to get mine, he's gonna pay over 200, and I paid 160 or 169.
Place. They have it for $179 now. I'll have to look around and see if there's anywhere that it has gone for less.
Yeah, I've had mine probably since the end of 23 now.
Yeah, yeah. And you've been happy with them, right?
Oh, I'm ecstatic. I love them. The only really real reason I have two is because they have one at each end of the operating station. So one of them is dedicated to the ICOM and the K4, and the other one is at the other end of the desk, you know, dedicated to the Flex and the Anon.
Roger.
And there you have it.
Good evening.
There's like signals everywhere.
From New York 4DX. Good evening, John.
Hey, Norman, how's it going?
Good, good, good. I was scanning the frequency and I heard Mark there upstairs, and also I heard you here. I was saying to myself, I monitored two of the good audios here in 40 meters. And good evening to the other stations there on monitor. I'm up here, KN6EYF from New York 4DX.
Yeah, very good, very good. Somebody's got to keep the ESSB alive. Oh, man. Other station is N9GDM, that's Mike in Colorado. Got Randy in Arizona floating out there somewhere, maybe. What are you using tonight?
Oh, right now, I'm using the 8000 DLE connected to the OM, yeah. Sounding good, sounding good. You're coming a pretty good signal here. You're 30 dB. I'm not sure how much power you're pushing there.
Yeah, I'm not